It's been 45 days on the Australian Survivor Island, but the castaways have been playing their toughest games yet. However, the pressure of keeping hidden immunity idols got to King Grubb Brian, where he prematurely played it, and Monika was sent packing. Take a look.
The plan for tonight is that Sean, Shane and myself will all write down Brian's name. I'm just going to pretend that I'm still 100% on board with Brian and Monika.
But she seems calm, Shane.
Is she?
Well, she's not panicking.
If Brian said, why is Shane not worried about tonight?
And now it's time to bring out my acting skills.
Of course.
Yeah, so it's between me and Shawnee then. I'm worried.
You and me both.
All afternoon I've been thinking he's been acting strange. He's too just blasé and not panic-stricken enough.
And I think he's got an idol.
If anyone has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Jonathan.
Monika,
yes.
The tribe has spoken.
Monika joins us now live in the studio. Now, Monika, we have all sorts of plot points and strategies to talk about, but first of all, girl to girl, you're a former Miss Universe Australia. What was it like to not wash your hair, not be in heels? Just what was that actually like? How many days did you go without washing your hair, all this? Tell me that sort of side of things.
47 days without washing my hair, shaving my legs, using a toothbrush. It was intense. But I've got to say, I quite reveled in the fact that I didn't have any of these products to use. And it was, you know, you worked with nature and what it gave you. So my routine was exfoliating with the sand and swimming in the ocean. And I felt great, to be honest.
Wow.
And you looked pretty great. Let's face it.
Did you have any idea that Brian had an idol?
I actually did.
Oh.
I knew he had an idol and I knew that he would play it because that was the last immunity that the tribal council that he could play it when there was five people left. But I thought we were going to vote out Shane and I thought Shawnee was on board 100%. So I was really relaxed and my last day on the island was just a great blissful one. I was so blissfully unaware.
Shane's a tricky one.
Mm-hmm.
She's amazing.
Yeah, pretty strong.
In fact, let's talk about her and her acting. Does she actually deserve an Academy Award for that acting?
I was fooled that day, I remember, and I thought, because I was so confident that we were voting her out, I thought she had reason to be upset and nervous about it all. So I was sort of acting, I'm so sorry, Shane. Oh, yeah, I know, it's really sad, thinking, well, at least it's not me going home tonight, and look, it was.
Do you regret steering away from your alliance?
No, I definitely don't regret that because, for me, my game plan was before the merge, we had to keep the tribe strong and my whole strategy was just staying there because I was not a physical threat whatsoever. And then when we did make it to merge, it was all about playing my own individual game and not listening to the head honchos because up until that point, they were pretty much telling me what to do, directing my gameplay. And I don't think I would have been proud of myself if I'd made it to the end, the final two, dictated by what somebody had told me to do. Mm-hmm. So I'm really proud that I got them out.
So you were sort of playing a social game strategy. Do you think this had to do with the fact that you've done a psychology degree?
Definitely. I definitely use that to my advantage. And what I did was sort of, instead of listening to what they were telling me, I was gauging their body language and seeing how they were actually behaving and if I could trust what they were telling me.
And it worked for you.
It worked.
46 days later, you were still there.
That's right. And my strategy also was just to make everyone believe me. And everyone did. So I had two sides, always thinking I'd play with them. And obviously one side was always upset with me. So I had to deal with that.
Who would you like to see crowned sole survivor?
They're all such different players. And as we've seen on the show, you can be up at the top one day and down at the bottom next. For me, I'd love to see Shawnee. She's such an underdog and I think it'll be so incredible to see her win and take it out.
You'd like that, but who do you think will? Is it a different answer?
No, it's not, because I think they've all got it in them. That's why they are there in the final four. So for me, though, I'd be super happy in cheering her on if she won.
Okay. Well, you have to tune in to finale week of Australian Survivor Champions versus Contenders to find out who will win. Kicks off next Monday, 7:30 p.m. on both the 10 and Win networks. Monika, you're a legend. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks.